Today, we're going to see how to work with different observation types. When your dataset contains several types of observations, for instance, a PK concentration and a PD biomarker concentration, for each observation line, the type of observations must be indicated using the observation ID column. This column assigns an identifier to each type of observation. In this example, the PK data has identifier 1, and the PD data identifier 2. For each observation identifier, I need to choose the type of data, here continuous. The match between the observation identifiers of the dataset and the model outputs is done in alphabetical order. Here, the first output, the concentration CC, is matched to the data with the first observation identifier in alphabetical order, which is identifier 1 and corresponds to the PK data. The second output, the effect E, is matched to the observations tagged with the second observation ID, number 2. In the GUI, the data is noted as Y, followed by the observation identifier, so Y1 for the PK data and Y2 for the PD data, and I can see how the matching has been done between the data and the model output CC and E. Any string or number can be used as identifier. It is often convenient to use integers such as 1, 2, 3. However, if you have more than 10 outputs, note that the ordering by alphabetical order leads to 1, 10, 2, 3, etc., which is misleading. In that case, it is easier to work with letters A, B, C, and so on. To better remember the meaning of the identifiers, you can also use 1_PK, 2_PD, etc. With this naming, we can easily see that the PK data has been matched to the concentration CC, for instance. It is also possible to have more observation types in the dataset than outputs in the model. If I keep the same dataset but have only one output in the model, for instance only CC, then the concentration CC is matched to the data with the lowest observation ID, here observation ID equals 1. And the PD observations are completely ignored, as we can see here. This is very convenient because with the same dataset, I can first model only the PK and then move to a PK-PD model. If, on the opposite, I would like to fit only the PD data and thus have only the effect E as model output, I have two options. The first one is to ignore all PK data in the dataset using the ignored observation column. In that case, the lowest observation identifier for non-ignored observations is 2, marking the PD data. In the GUI, I can see that the model prediction for the effect E is matched to the data tagged with observation ID equals 2, written as Y2. The second option to match only output E to the PD data is to manually edit the .mlxtrand project file. In the project file, we see that the two observation types are called Y1 and Y2 according to the observation identifiers 1 and 2. We also see that the prediction E is used to define a random variable called Y1. The two Y1 are matched with each other in the fit section. I can edit the fit section to say that the random variables representing the model should be matched with the data Y2 instead of Y1. Now this is a bit confusing to match Y1 with Y2, so what I can also do is to rename this Y1 into Y2. So this is a second option if you want to match the PD data with observation ID equals 2 to the model output E. In this example, I have used the PK-PD dataset, but this procedure works with any number of outputs and every type of data. Until now, we have focused on continuous data, but it is also very easy to develop models for both continuous and non-continuous data. A number of examples are available in the demos. For instance, continuous and count, continuous and time to event, or continuous and categorical examples. If I load the PK time to event project, we see that the principle is exactly the same. In the dataset, each type of observation is tagged with a different identifier, and the data is matched by alphabetical order with the different model outputs. And we can see the match in the GUI here. All this information can also be found on our online documentation. See you next week!